In this video, I am going to talk about palette operations which are available in Integration Flow Editor. In SAP CPI, we have a tool called Integration Flow Editor where we create integration scenarios. In this flow editor, SAP has provided many palette operations with which we can create complex integration scenarios. In this part 1 series of palette operations, I am going to talk about participants, process, and events. Let's get started. Under participants, we have sender and receiver. They represent the sender and receiver of your integration flow. You can choose different adapter types for a sender system and a receiver system. Basically, a sender and receiver system represent the remote systems which are participating in the integration scenario. Let's now cover some aspects of process palette operation. Under process, we have three different types of processes: exception subprocess, integration process, and local integration process. We can use exception subprocess to create error handling logic in your integration flow. In integration process, you should define the main flow for your integration scenario. You can create local integration process to define a common error handling logic that can be invoked by integration flow. Basically, we can use local integration process to call it as child processes from an integration flow. To invoke a local integration process from a main integration process, we can use process direct adapter. Let's now talk about events. In SAP CPI, we have different types of events. For example, we have end event, end message, error end event, error start event, escalation end event, start event, start message, terminate message. And finally, we have timer. We can use end event to end a local integration process that performs some transformation logic and returns the control to the main integration process. You can use end message event to wrap the exception in a fault message and send it back to the sender in the payload. You can use end error event to throw an exception to default exception handler or put the message back into the queue for retrying. You can use error start event to catch any exception thrown in the main integration process and handle them in an exception subprocess. You can use escalation end event to end the message with an escalation status and persist for monitoring and alerting. You can use start event to start a local integration process that performs some error handling logic and returns the control to the exception subprocess. We can use start message event to receive a message from an HTTP sender and trigger the main integration flow. You can use terminate message event to stop further processing of a message that does not match any routing conditions in the content router. Finally, you can use a timer event to start an integration process and to poll regularly at a given interval of time.